The Girl on the Train is the thriller novel that shocked the world and broke every record for book sales in publishing history. Last year, a copy was sold every 20 seconds. Mm-hmm. Now, in the book, divorced alcoholic Rachel Watson is the girl on the train who thinks she spots a terrible crime in one of the houses she passes every day. It was even made into a movie starring Emily Blunt. Have a look.
I used to watch this perfect couple. They were the embodiment of true love.
I saw her from the train.
Can you tell me where you were Friday night?
I was in the city, and then I went to visit my husband.
You mean your ex-husband? It's my understanding that the woman who has gone missing was his nanny.
Hey, Tom.
Hey, Megan.
Just tell me what happened that night.
Why are you here?
Because I'm afraid of myself.
Look, the movie was good, but the book was 10 yes. times better. And author Paula Hawkins is back with a brand new thriller, and she joins us now from London. Paula Hawkins, welcome to the show.
Hooray!
Thank you very much.
I loved this book, yes. We all did, and so did the rest of the world. It broke a stack of records and made you lots and lots of money, which is very different to the scenario you found yourself in back in 2013 when you were flat broke and writing chick lit novels.
I wrote four romantic comedies under a pseudonym, Amy Silver, and a couple of them did fine, and one of them did, the last one did terribly, and nobody bought it, and so I had to do something else. I either was going to go back to journalism or I had to change what I was writing. And I came up with this idea for a thriller about a drunk woman who witnesses something on her train commute, and the rest is history.
Mm-hmm. And it is such a compelling read. Did you ever have any idea it would be quite so successful?
Well, you know, my publishers and my agent were optimistic, and I was cautiously optimistic, but nobody predicted that it would go as crazy as it ended up going, actually.
You were a journalist for 15 years, so we sort of all know where you're coming from. I suppose we all hope we've got a book in us. But the main character, Rachel, is someone we can all relate to through the book, despite her issues. Were you happy with her portrayal in the film?
I thought Emily Blunt did an amazing job at playing Rachel, because it's not an easy thing to do, to play a fall-down drunk without making it sort of laughable and ridiculous. And the thing about Rachel is that she's tragic and self-loathing, and I thought Emily did that amazingly and brought out all the pathos in that character. I thought she was fantastic.
And Paula, of course, it's not just a story about a murder, it's also a story about the woman's struggle with alcoholism and addiction. Which sort of came first? Was it the struggle or the murder? How did that come about?
Well, it was the character of Rachel, really. I'd had this idea for this woman who had a drink problem. The drink problem wasn't really the thing. The thing was her memory loss, because as a result of her drinking, she has blackouts. And that was the thing that I was first interested in, like how would not remembering your actions affect you? How would it affect your sense of responsibility, your sense of your guilt, that kind of thing. So that came first. So it was the character first, and then I sort of built a story around her.
And you've said that The Girl on the Train was your last attempt at being a writer. In fact, though, you've got your new novel that's out today. I can't wait for it to be downloaded on my Kindle. Did you know that there was something special happening with it?
It's a very, this Into the Water is a very different story. It's got a much wider cast of characters. It's got a very different setting. But I think at its core, it's dealing with some of the same themes about women's relationships to each other, about the deceitfulness of memory. And I'm hoping that it'll maintain that kind of that creepy, sinister, paranoid atmosphere that I managed to conjure up in the first book.
When you have a hit book on your hands, you often hear about this second book syndrome that writers face. The writer of Eat, Pray, Love, she was so desperate to make her second book fantastic that it almost paralysed her when she was writing it. Did you have that sort of experience as well, writing your latest novel?
It was certainly trickier in some ways. There was a different sort of pressure on me than there had been the first time round. And it was a much more interrupted process just because the girl on the train had taken off in such a huge way. I was touring and doing loads of publicity and other things, so I didn't have the time that I wanted to immerse myself in quite the way that I would have desired. But actually, you know, over time it worked out. But it took a lot longer than I thought. It's taken me the best part of 3 years to write. So wow. It was more interrupted.
Mm. Well, Into the Water is out today. Are you about to embark on another book tour?
I am, yes. I'll be starting tomorrow. I'm going to be doing some touring in the UK, and then I'm off to the United States for a couple of weeks after that, and then I'll be in Europe for a while.
Mm-hmm. Will this one hit Hollywood as well, do you think?
It's been optioned as well by DreamWorks, so the same producers who did the Girl on the Train, but it's very early days. They're just talking to writers at the moment to see who's going to write the screenplay.
So not talking to stars or celebrities at the moment?
I'm available, Paula.
Not just yet. No, we're not there.
Now, Paula, I understand that you have a pretty beautiful office that you do your writing in. I think we've got a picture of it there. I would just daydream in that place. How do you actually get any work done?
Well, I actually really enjoy the writing. That's the part of my job that I like most of all. So it's no hardship to be writing. I actually really look forward to it. Now I have so many other things I have to do. It's the thing that I long to get back to.
Because writing is something that you've done your entire life. Is it true that as a little girl you were writing novels even then?
Well, I used to make up a lot of stories. I'm not sure I'd call them novels, but they were... as a child, I liked to write stories. And then, you know, as a teenager in my 20s, I sort of started a lot of probably very, very terrible novels that never got finished.
Always
been something that I've wanted to do.
Mm-hmm. When you're writing, do you actually withdraw? Do you cut everybody out of your life and sort of become a mole?
I would like to, but... It's not always possible. That for me is probably the ideal way of working, is just to cut everyone out. But it's not always possible.
No. Well, Into the Water by Paula Hawkins is available today, so you can grab your copy. Paula Hawkins, thank you so much for joining us. We do appreciate it.
Thank you, Paula.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.